Well, we're in the test cell getting ready for mounting another engine, and I finally decided to answer a question that's been asked many times. People ask, how does that thing not fly away? What's holding it down? What's holding it to the ground? Well, let's take a look down at the ground. And there's our test skid. What I'm going to do is show you what's holding it to the ground. It's got 8 of these pillars sunk 16 feet into the ground, cast in concrete. And this is the front mounting frame sitting here. There's an idea of the thickness of the material. And these are the bolts. We'll be doing up the front hoop after we get the engine in, but right now we're just getting the skid ready to accept the afterburning J79. So let's take a quick look at how it's built. Okay, here we are in the test cell. We're gonna start bolting down the frame that holds the J79. So, I'm gonna show you what we use. All right, that's a structural steel bolt. There's gonna be about 16 of them holding the engine down. And they're torqued to, the torque is as much as you can get with a wrench like this. It's a 1⅛ wrench, so let's give that a go. Let's get another one. Get it started. And then, okay. That's one. Okay, this is the rear frame that's gonna resist all of the thrust produced by the afterburning J79. It's made of structural steel, and it weighs around, 500-600 pounds. Let's take a closer look at what it's made of. Okay, we had this fabbed up by a local welder. There's the thickness of the material there. It's about 3/16 of an inch structural steel. It's a big ugly thing, but it does have to resist a little over 10 tons of thrust. Let's get a look at it there. Right there. Okay, we're going to bolt that in position right now. Okay, we've got one of our force transducers sort of mounted. We just got to do up the bolts. So I guess these four bolts, these two here and those two on the other side, they hold back the entire thrust of the engine. But they're up to the job. Look what happens when you take off for lunch and you come back. The J79 is hung in the test cell, and I'll show you what holds it to the stand right here. These great big solid steel pins. They go into mounts in the rear frame. There's one there that isn't used. Very solid, not going anywhere. That's what holds your J79 into the test stand. There's our load cell. Did I show you that? This is a piezoelectric load cell with a capacity of 10,000 pounds. So 20,000 for the both of them. This engine should make a maximum of about 18.5 in afterburner. So we've got a small safety margin, don't we? There you go. We've got the engine installed, basically in the stands. We've still got to hook everything up. The test is going to be in a week or so. But you can see, hopefully, how sturdy all of the bracketry and mounting hardware is. There we go. This is the front hoop. Those are the bolts. Structural steel, 6x6 square tubing. So this is what's going to hold our engine from flying away. We have yet to make any connections for instrumentation, oil, coolant, fuel. And there's the flame holder for the afterburner. And right here, right behind it, that's what's going to be stuck to the back of the engine. This is the afterburner jet pipe. You've seen one of these before. I just thought you might want to see it in its uninstalled condition. So it's going to be a week or so, maybe two, before we have this thing running with afterburner. But stay tuned, because I'll be sure to film that. Everybody loves afterburners. Thanks for watching.